About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, we are going to be talking about Golden Retrievers. Now, I was supposed to have two guests. Unfortunately, my guest who is going to be talking about the show Goldens is still stuck in New Jersey, so she didn't make it. But we do have Joe LaCisco, and he has a Field Golden, and he's going to be telling us about the differences between the show Golden and the Field Golden and what he actually does with his dog, because he is very strong into the hunt tests. So he's going to tell us a little bit about that, because I know I don't have a hunting dog, so I don't know anything about it. So anyhow, welcome, Joe. And I guess my first question is, what is the difference between the show Golden and the Field Golden? Obviously, the first thing that I see is the coat. It doesn't have nearly as much coat as...
Right. My guy here, this is Yukon. He's a six-year-old Golden. He was bred for field. As you can see, he has more of a pointed nose, more of a pointed snout, and he's a lot trimmer in back in the withers here.
Well, he's resting. Yukon, we can get up now.
Yeah.
Yukon, you don't really need to be such a good dog.
Let's go. That's a good boy.
That's better. So you can see the feathering is not nearly as profuse.
No. And the one thing that Field Goldens must bring to the table is the drive to retrieve game. And that could be ducks, that could be pheasants, that could be chuckers. They must have that desire to go out and run through any kind of cover or run through water and be able to pick up the bird and bring it back to the owner.
Well, how does it know what you want it to get? I mean, suppose there are ducks and pheasants in the same field. How do they know what you want them to retrieve? Especially if you only winged it.
What we do is we teach our dogs, our Goldens, when we go to put birds down in the field,
okay,
he will sit alongside of me, just like you would in obedience,
uh-huh,
and he will watch people out in the field putting birds down, shooting birds.
Oh, okay.
And it may be one over here, one in the middle, and one over on the right. And as he's watching them, he's marking where they fell. And then you send him for that bird. He goes out, picks it up, and brings it back. And it may be 100 yards.
Uh-huh.
And then after he comes back and it delivers to hand to the owner, you'll turn him and you send him for the middle one, and you turn him and send him for the left one. And his reward for everything is picking up the bird. That's his word. So he has to have that desire, and he's never finished. Three birds is... He could keep going all day long.
Oh, my word.
Yeah. He has a lot of desire. He also, this dog here is a master hunter. He's an AKC retriever master hunter. But in addition to that, he also has his companion dog title.
Oh, very good in obedience.
Exactly. Because field work is not anything different than obedience. All it really is field work at 100 yards.
Okay.
That's all.
Obedience work at 100 yards.
Yeah, so exactly.
You're really controlling them at a long distance away
from
you. Well, we'll get into the master hunter later. But the other difference is between, they don't look as stocky.
No, they're not.
Is that because they need to be lighter to get over the brush or under the brush?
Well, they need to be lighter because if they do a lot of retrieving, you don't want them to have all that extra weight that as they get older,
mm-hmm,
they're going to get hurt by it.
Okay.
You know, if they sprain a ligament or a hip or something like that. So if you have a dog who's weighs in his 50s, he'll be able to go longer and work longer during the day. Because you figure when you do what they call upland hunting, which is when there's birds out in the field, he doesn't know where they're at. He's going back and forth, right, swinging back and forth, and you may do that 4 or 5 hours.
Wow.
And if you have a dog who weighs 80 pounds, and it's like a day today when it's 70 degrees out,
right,
it's going to wear the dog down.
Sure, they're going to get way more tired
exactly,
out.
Exactly.
I mean, just carrying the extra weight.
Exactly.
But I think they're also heavier. The show goldens are also heavier in bone. Of course, with the show golden, it's, they're looking at not necessarily only conformation, but they're looking at the beauty of the dog,
right,
which is, you know, the right, correct head style. And now, how did they split so dramatically? Now, it's not to say that a show golden can't hunt.
Oh, absolutely. And there are dogs. There are show goldens. There are goldens out there who have otches.
Okay.
And they are a master hunter.
Okay.
It takes time to do that,
mm-hmm,
and normally you have to focus on one or the other,
right,
because of the level of the training and everything.
Sure,
but there are dogs out there, if it's in their background where they had a field champion, they'll do the work.
Mm-hmm,
they'll,
mm-hmm,
you know, if you take a show golden out in the field and you're running through briars and things like that, I've had to clean him up. It takes an hour and a half sometimes.
Yeah.
And if you put a show golden out there, well, I'd hate to see what some
right,
of those.
That's exactly,
you know,
right.
They,
with all that coat.
The last thing they want to do is start cutting hair off the dog.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know. But these guys, their desire never quits.
Yeah.
Never quits. They and even though these are field dogs, they're in the house with us 24/7.
Oh, yeah. You know, you want them to work for
exactly,
you, so you want them to be, you know, at least on the
part
same
of the family
level. That's exactly right.
Right,
you know,
exactly.
Yeah, they're bringing your supper, quote unquote,
yeah,
which is basically
oh, yeah,
what they were supposed to be doing.
Oh, yeah.
But now, they also don't have as much. It doesn't seem like their ears are as heavy either. I mean,
no.
It looks like almost a other than the color. By the way, folks, a golden retriever is gold. They don't come in any other color.
Right.
They come in various, as you can see, that is gold.
Mm-hmm.
They come in various shades of gold,
mm-hmm,
like, you know, from the lighter gold almost to a light, light golden color, all the, like a, you know, a blonde, an ultralight blonde, all the way down to almost like the red Irish setter gold.
Right.
But they only come in gold. I've had people call the Kennel Club and say they want a golden retriever, but they don't want it in gold. It's like, well, what other color did you want? That's why
right,
you're buying a golden, because it's gold.
Right.
The Labrador retrievers are the ones that come in the yellow. It's not a gold. It's yellow, chocolate, and black. And I think sometimes people get confused with that. But the whole, when you look at it, you say, yes, it's a golden retriever, but it's not that. You say, wow, look at the coat on that, look at the ears on that, look at the tail on that, because everything,
yeah,
and it's a shame that our other guest couldn't make it, because it really would have been a distinctive difference. But
right,
I think she also, like you said, she does hunting with her
right,
dogs as well.
Right. Now, and that's another thing with golden retrievers. A lot of people buy them for the wrong reasons. They need exercise. They,
mm-hmm,
they cannot stay in the house 2, 3, 4 days. Before I came tonight, we went for a 20-minute walk.
Mm-hmm.
And that just lets their energy out,
right,
you know? And if you don't do that, you're going to have a problem with the dog.
Sure.
You know? And they love to run. These guys love to run, and they'll come back to me on a whistle,
mm-hmm,
you know? And they love to retrieve. Now, right now, Yukon has his winter coat yet.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
He still does. He still has a fair amount of undercoat,
uh-huh,
there.
Uh-huh.
I'm kind of surprised he didn't blow that yet.
Yeah, because it's really been warm.
Yeah. And the reason I know he didn't blow it, because my wife didn't tell me that we have hair all over
the
sofa. Yeah. So when I hear that, I know he blew his coat, you know.
And you obviously know he's a family dog, since
yeah,
it's all over the sofa.
Yeah. Yeah. But that'll happen shortly with this warm weather.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah. Now, does he go into the water as well? Are they supposed to go into the water too, just like a lab?
Oh yeah, these guys will go in the water at any temperature. The rule of thumb for us when we train is that the water should be 55 degrees.
Yeah.
If you have a couple days where you can have a couple days where the air temperature is really cool, but you had water temperature that might have been 60, and you can mm-hmm. still put
mm-hmm.
them in.
Mm-hmm.
And when he was a puppy, I can still remember the first day he went in the water. He was only 12 weeks old.
Oh, my word.
He was only 12 weeks old, and I stepped in the water with boots on. My other dog, Hoss, was already in the water, and he just went in, and he just does the doggy paddle, you know. And it was a matter of minutes he picked it up.
Wow.
He had an idea, you
yeah.
know. And you kind of wonder, does he sink and he's going to sink or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But they feel so much more comfortable in the water.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
His coat is so light that the breeder I got him for, he's almost a wash and wear dog. It dries off.
Yeah.
It dries
yeah.
off
mm-hmm.
so quick.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so... And he doesn't have any ear infections, which some Goldens have a tendency
yes.
to get because of the long, floppy ear.
Right.
You know, and if you don't dry that out, that'll develop an ear infection.
Well, yeah, because it stays wet all the time.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly. Exactly.
Now, what were they developed from? What breeds were mixed in with them to develop the Golden Retriever?
I'm not sure, to be honest with you. I know they were a dog from England.
Uh-huh.
And... Their objective over in England is a little bit different than the way they do it in the U.S. They place birds out in the field, and you're supposed to send the dog to the bird that the judges want you to pick up.
Oh, okay.
It's a little bit different than it is over here, and you may have six or seven field dogs sitting, and they'll say, dog number 10, go pick up bird number 4, and there might be 1 through 7, and he has X amount of time to find that
wow.
bird, and if he doesn't, they call the dog back, they sit him down, and they bring another dog out to do it.
Oh,
you know,
okay.
It's a little bit
yeah.
different over there than it is here.
Right.
You know, ours is more involved. We put birds down, and they have to remember where the birds
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
were placed.
Well, now, do you need to shoot?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, what we normally do is you'll have 3 birds go down, one at a time, and the first 2 might be what they call dead birds.
Okay.
They'll be hand-thrown, and a shot will be shot in the air. And the third one will be what they call a flyer, which is a bird that is that one of the gentlemen out in the field throws the flyer, the dog flaps his wings like he's going to fly away, and then they shoot the bird.
Okay.
And it's the dog has to pick up that bird. And the bird could be wounded, but the dog has to be able to find that bird, bring that bird back to heel,
mm-hmm.
to the left
mm-hmm.
side, sit down, and when I say give, he drops the bird out of his mouth.
Okay.
And then we turn around and do it for the next 2.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then when we've done that on land, then what they do is they will put a bird out in the field somewhere, say over here, and it'll be 100 yards. And this dog will not see where that bird went. He's back
oh.
in a holding blind.
Okay.
You bring the dog back out, you sit him down, and you say, dead bird. Now, what this simulates is if you're in a hunting blind, in a duck blind, and the dog's sitting outside the duck blind, and you got 3 guys in the back of the duck blind, and they all stand up and shoot, and say they get 4 birds. Dogs may not remember 4 birds.
Right, right.
He may only see 2 of them.
Sure.
So the other 2 are what they call dead birds. So anyways, you line the dog up, and you tell him dead bird. And he is trained that when I say the word back, he runs straight out.
Okay.
Now, if he gets offline,
mm-hmm.
and offline would be outside the 2 fingers here,
mm-hmm.
you stop him on a whistle.
Okay.
He turns around, sits, watches you, and then you give him a cast. If you give him a left cast, he needs to turn left. If you give him a right cast, he needs to turn right. That depends how far offline he is.
Okay.
And then if you really don't have to give what they call backs, lefts and rights, maybe he might be just a little bit off. So you whistle sit, he turns around, and you'll give an angle. And he'll learn to take an angle. And while he's doing this, he has to go back further.
Mm-hmm.
And he's probably running through water and brush and everything else. And he may even be running through other birds, other bird scent.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's anybody who sees that kind of work is really impressed by
yes,
it.
Yes, I
you
can
know,
imagine. Before you go on, hold that thought, we need to take a break. So we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed, be involved, be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. All About Dogs is underwritten by the Berks County Kennel Club and by Berks Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
And we're back. Now, you were telling us about the long distance mm-hmm. and the signals. So how would you start? I would assume that you start this by strictly obedience to start with.
Everything that a retriever is taught is first taught along the heel position.
Okay.
And with a leash.
Okay.
From that, you go to a long line, and from that, you take him off the long line, and he understands what you want.
Uh-huh.
You know, some guys train with an electric collar, but you don't teach the dog with it. That's just to reinforce what they already know.
Right.
You know, but it takes... For a dog to be at the level I've just talked about, it takes a good 2 to 3 years.
Wow.
Just to be at the level. That doesn't make him the best.
Right.
It just means that you could take him with a bunch of guys hunting,
mm-hmm.
and you wouldn't have to be afraid of... A lot of dogs, when you put birds up, the first thing they do is they run out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not allowed. They
right.
cannot break. But a dog like this, he will sit there for you,
uh-huh.
and he will watch all the game go down, and then you send him on his name for the game,
right,
you know.
Right.
But it does it like I said, little 2 to 3 years, and then you could take him out hunting. Now, as far as upland hunting goes, I've already taken these guys out at 6 months.
Okay.
But the only reason I was able to do that is because they learn a lot from their brothers and sisters.
Oh, sure.
You know. And in fact, all my guys have learned from their older brother,
mm-hmm.
you know, like from Hoss or from Brandy or whoever, or Duke or whoever,
right.
you know. So
now, did you start with Goldens because you wanted to get into hunting, or how
no.
did you get started in Goldens?
No,
because I remember, you know, a couple of years ago, you weren't that involved, and now you're a hunting judge.
Yeah,
you really got involved.
Yeah, I had Irish setters first.
Okay,
and I moved into my house on a Saturday, and I got my first dog on a Sunday, and I ruined him for hunting.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought. The next dog I get, I'm going to learn more and a lot more about what it takes to have a good hunting dog or a good companion. I went to Berks County Dog Training Club, took Brandy through the beginner's class, ended up getting a UD, ended up taking her hunting with me. She was very proficient at picking up game, especially pheasants. And then I had Duke, and I went from junior to senior to master hunter. And one thing led to another. And when you're out there with your buddies hunting, like I hunted a couple years ago when I had Duke down in York County, and we shot some geese, and the one goose that we shot didn't drop for 300 yards.
Wow.
And we were in a field, it was snow covered, and I didn't realize the goose was that far out, and the guy that was with me said, "Hey, Joe, that one you shot is 300 yards out." I said, "Well, I can't see that." He said, "Well, it's that little speck out there by the telephone pole." long story short, I got Duke to go out there with hand signals, pick up the bird, bring it back, come back, bring it back to heel position. I said, give. He dropped it out of his mouth. The goose was still alive. The guy that was with me said, I'm impressed.
Wow.
I mean, and this was before that. There was geese walking around within 25 yards
sure.
of us. So
sure.
That whole thing, you know, I've developed a very special bond, you know.
Your dog.
Yeah.
And I think the more you work with them, the closer you become. They almost
absolutely.
Can read your mind.
Absolutely.
You know,
and
they know what you're thinking.
Which is why any dog should have at least have their CD.
Right.
Really. I mean, that's a very important part of it, because it's all obedience, you know.
But it's, you know, it's hard to tell a new dog person that how you develop that real close bond, and the dog just knows.
Oh, yeah.
But the more you work with them, it's just the more they learn, the better they get, the better companions they are.
When these guys see me take the shotgun out, they're already sitting at the truck.
Yes.
They already want to go. They're already on the go. So, you know, they like the work, and you almost got to be able to understand. You got to be able that maybe, you know, like today is a hot day, so you got to watch how much
mm-hmm.
you do in the training
sure.
side.
Sure.
You know, so you got to know when to back off and everything.
Right.
You know, but when it comes time to train, they're off the charts,
mm-hmm.
you know. So
now, how much exercise do they actually require on a daily basis?
If
someone was interested in getting a field golden,
I would suggest that they be walked every day
mm-hmm.
at a minimum 20 minutes.
Okay.
These guys go for a walk. Since they're really now in maintenance mode as far as training goes, they go for a walk 4 times a week, at least 2 miles a day.
Okay.
And sometimes even longer,
mm-hmm,
you
mm-hmm.
know. And even the 2-mile walk, because we'll walk in the woods, even the 2-mile walk after that, they're not done.
They're not tired.
They're not done. They're not done. Give me some water. I'm ready to do it again.
Okay.
But you know, even if you got a couple days of rain, we go out in the rain.
Sure.
You have to. Yeah, they just can't be left in the house, because they become destructive.
Oh, sure.
You know.
They get rid of that energy somehow.
I found out when I had Irish setters, my first Irish setter used to dig a lot of holes in the yard.
Mm-hmm.
And someone said, well, why is that? They're bored. They're bored. They need these,
mm-hmm.
like any other dog, whether it be a Sheldie or whatever, they need a job.
Yes.
They need a purpose.
Yes.
And their purpose is to retrieve game.
Yes.
You know.
That's what they were bred for.
Exactly. And it doesn't have to be just a feel. I mean, you know, there's show goldens out there that can do the work too.
Well, sure. That's
you know.
Exactly right.
Yeah.
And with a golden, they basically can do almost anything you want to do.
Oh, yeah.
It's an all-around dog.
This guy is only 6, and I promise myself I'm going to get a CDX on him.
Very good.
We're there. He's just not finished.
Mm-hmm.
And I need to make that commitment, and he'll be able to do the work.
Yes.
You know.
That's exactly right.
You
That's
know.
Exactly right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, you mentioned junior hunter. How many levels are there?
There's junior, senior, and master.
Okay.
And in the junior hunter, you need 4 passes. And when you are tested at each level, you are tested against a standard.
Okay.
My dog's not tested against a Chesapeake Bay Retriever or Labrador. There's a standard that the AKC has established, and you must get a score of at least 7.
Okay.
So junior is 4 passes, senior is 4 passes, and master is 5 passes. Now, not to brag, but he never went through junior or senior.
Oh.
He went right to master.
Wow.
So the fact that he went to master, he had to do 6.
Yes.
And he was 6 for 8.
Wow, that's great.
Before he was 3.
Uh-huh.
Before he was 3, which...
That's phenomenal.
Yeah, he's... I've become a better trainer because he's my 4th golden.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a top flight dog. He's a good dog.
Yeah.
He does want to work for you. But you gotta...
But he has that that in the background as well. His parents were field trial champions, and you know, you went back a couple of years, and you know, you have field champion. Well, obviously, that instinct is getting stronger and stronger and stronger.
His mother is from England, and his grandmother is a field trial champion from England. His dad is a field champion, California. You know.
So, you know, he's got it in the bloodline.
Absolutely.
He's got it in the bloodline.
And it would be a waste not to do that.
That's exactly right.
You know.
That's exactly right.
And he's talented enough to do obedience, too.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if I had the time, I'd probably even do agility, but...
there are only so many hours in a day.
Field work takes a lot of work.
Oh, yes.
It really does.
Yes, and he wanted to be proficient in any of the dog sports. It takes a lot of time.
Exactly. Exactly.
Well, I thank you very much, Joe. I knew nothing about hunting, and now I do. I do want to remind people that if you are interested in training your dog, we do have a beginner's class coming up with the Berks County Dog Training Club, April the 24th. So the telephone number and the email address is at the end of the program. So contact the Berks County Dog Training Club. I think you can still get in. If you want more information about Golden Retrievers, call the Kennel Club, and we will put you in touch either with Joe and the field dogs or with my other guest who isn't here, and we will go that route. Also, the Berks County Dog Training Club has their obedience and rally trial coming up in May. I think it's May the 20th, but we'll talk about that more next month. So for this evening, good night. ¶¶